Now she coming up before Peter, going to get her husband, right? Go ahead and read.
And Peter answered unto her, tell me, whether ye sold the land for so much. And she said, yeah, for so much.
Now maybe if she'd have said, hey, my husband, he took the money. You know, maybe if she'd have, we didn't give you the money, we should have, maybe she, if she'd have copped the plea, maybe the Lord would have had compassion. But she gonna lie. Please, yeah, for so much. Go ahead and read.
Then Peter said unto her, how is it that ye have agreed together to tempt the spirit of the Lord? Behold, the feet of them which have buried thy husband are at the door, and shall carry thee out. Then fell she down straightway at his feet, and yielded up the ghost.
You see that? So sometimes money could get you in lots of trouble, even death. So you got to be careful about what you do and what you say. Let's go to Psalm 37, because, you know, sometimes, hey, man, ain't nothing wrong with having a little bit. You know, if you get it in right, if you got a little in right, it's better than getting much gain in wickedness. You know, you can sleep with a, because I don't think no servant of God can sleep with a clear conscience knowing he done did wrong by getting some money. Be scared half to death, because he got to know that the Lord is coming to collect.
That's right.
You got to know. Psalms 37. Gonna pick it up at verse 16. 37 and 16. Go ahead and read.
A little that a righteous man hath is better than the riches of many wicked.
See, a little that, you know, a little that a righteous, in other words, a guy that's walking or a sister that's walking in the word of God, they got a little, it's much better than the riches of a wicked person. Doing all kinds of wrong getting that money. Because we understand what his end gonna be. Because I don't care what situation you're in, the Lord going to make sure you got your necessities. Skip on down to verse 23 and read.
The steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord, and he delighteth in his way.
Go ahead.
Though he fall, he shall not be utterly cast down.
You know, the steps of a good man, he going to walk in God's divine order. He may make a mistake or two down the way, but the Lord is able to uphold him. That is what's so good about the blood of Jesus. When you recognize that you have made a mistake, you get down on your knees and you ask the Lord to forgive you in the name of Jesus. That is what he came and died for. He is our intercessor. He is standing between you and the Father. That is what he came to die. But as long as you don't go out there sinning presumptuously, you understand? In other words, not caring, just doing it. But you know, we're going to make mistakes. That's why I say when you come under the blood of Jesus, you shouldn't serve sin. Not saying you will not sin, but you should not serve it. When you serve it, that means you have it in your mind that you're going to do it. Go ahead and read some more.
For the Lord upholdeth him with his hand.
Uh-huh.
I have been young, and now I'm old. Yet have I not seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread.
You have never seen the righteous forsaken, and I ain't never seen a man of God out there begging for bread. Never seen it. I haven't. Because you know what? The Lord going to make sure you get what he need. Somebody going to come around. We seen one of our brothers and sisters, and we know they are serving the God, and they are without. One of them brothers and sisters going to come, hey, man, I got something at home. What are you doing? Come on home with me. Let's go a little further. Let's go to Luke's the 4th chapter. Because just because a brother or sister got lots of money and you know he walking in wickedness, you know that ain't from the Lord. Let's find out who that's from. Let's go to Luke the 4th chapter. You know, yeah, God blessed, but somebody else blessed too. Luke 4. Gonna look at when Satan was tempting the Lord once again. See some of the things he got to dangle in front of your eyes. Okay. Luke 4 and 5. Go ahead and read.
And the devil, taking him up into an high mountain, shewed unto him all the kingdoms of the world in a moment of time.
So Lord, Satan, he showed the Lord all the kingdoms of earth in a moment of a time. Watch what Satan say. Go ahead and read.
And the devil said unto him, all this power will I give thee, and the glory of them, for that is delivered unto me.
See, it's given to him. He got power and glory that he can give to you too. These worldly things, that's why when you see these guys that's rich and got everything they want, everything they need, and much more, and ain't serving God, that blessing is from this guy, okay. Satan. He blessed also. Yeah. Go ahead and read.
And to whomsoever I will, I give it.
And he could give it to them anytime they want it, as long as they serving him. Now he don't have to worry about you, because the majority of these rich brothers and all these celebrities that's doing these, got all this money, they bring a lot of people with them. Bring a whole lot of people with them. So they ain't doing what the Lord say do. Go ahead and read.
If thou therefore wilt worship me, and all shall be thine.
And he will give that to you if you worship him. But you know you can't worship him. You don't want these blessings, because you know what's going to come behind that. Go ahead and read.
And Jesus answered and said unto him, get thee behind me, Satan, for it is written, thou shalt worship the Lord thy God, and him only shalt thou serve.
I don't care what kind of position, whatever you're going, what situation you in, you stick with the Lord. And believe that your God can deliver. That's why he got things like what happened to Job. He put that there for a reason. Job had plenty of money and everything, but the Lord brought him down very low. But then the Lord gave him double after it was all said and done, after the smoke cleared up. All you got to do is trust in the Lord. Believe in him. Because the Lord, Satan, you know, the Lord going to allow Satan to do some things. Sometimes the Lord might even pick you. He told Satan, have you considered my servant Job?
Okay.
How about him? You want to give him a try? Lord, don't change, man. You just got to stick. When you're going through some things, hey, man, you don't lean to your own understanding. You put your trust in the Lord, and he'll guide your ways, man. You got to trust in him. That is the one to trust in. Let's go a little further. Let's go to Proverbs, the 13th chapter. Because sometimes, you know, brothers done left doing wrong to become poor, to serve God. And then some people have stopped doing what the Lord say do, and to get riches and gain, start walking wicked. You can't do that, man. Because when you turn down things for the word of God, you rich. You rich in Christ. He gonna tell you this. Because you know what you got coming. Proverbs 13 and 7. Proverbs 13. And we're gonna pick it up at verse 7. Proverbs 13 and 7. 13 and 7. Proverbs 13, and we're going to pick it up at verse 7. When you get there, go ahead and read.
There is that maketh himself rich, yet hath nothing.
Because, you know, there's some guys out there, they make themselves rich, but spiritually, they have nothing. Go ahead and read.
There is that maketh himself poor, yet hath great riches.
Because he done stored, you know, some brothers done turned away from doing wrong, how they used to make their money. They used to do wicked things. And then they found out about the word of God. They say, I can't do this no more. Now they done stored them up some riches in heaven now. That is what he's saying here. Skip on down to verse 11 and read.
Wealth gotten by vanity shall be diminished.
You know, you get that fast money, that wicked money, it's going to be diminished. Go ahead and read.
But he that gathereth by labor shall increase.
Yeah, you got to labor. You got to work. The book even says you don't work, you don't eat.
Yes, sir.
You got to work. Can't lay around. Brother don't want to work and always got his hand out. You need a job. Go a little further. You know, because we as a people, man, listen here, man. The Lord said he was going to put us on the bottom, and that's all right.
That's what we're
at. That's all right. But we all got what we need, you know. But the Lord let you know, hey, man, you rich, though. He going to let you know here. Israel as a whole, hey, man, we ain't got much material wealth, but we are rich.
Yeah.
That's why, you know, let's go to Revelation, the second chapter. Lord talking to the seven churches here, and we're going to look at the church he's talking to. It's one of the churches he's talking to. Because we are the people, we going through some things, sisters and brothers, and it's not going to get no better. The only one going to deliver us is the Lord. And we got to trust in him. Lord, see all what we going through, though, as a people. As a people. And those that are serving God. I'm talking about not only Israel, spiritual Israel. Those that serve the true and living God. Revelation 2, and we're going to pick it up at verse 8.